conversation, but his heart was so full of love and empathy for anybody and everybody who is suffering a social issue, such as homelessness, mental health, trauma, and addiction, that he was able to connect with everybody.
Was it his compassion that drew you to the work, Michael?
Yes, definitely. He really inspired me to get more involved, reach out, and just, he really reminded me that in the homeless community, they're often not treated as people, and it's so important that they feel that, because they are. It's easy to forget that.
And I know that you look after Pete's at the Sparkle Fund. We're going to tell you about an event that you can participate in a little bit later on in the program, but I wanted to talk about the work that they did and how you found yourself sort of in under his umbrella of love, and he kind of lined you up when you were in recovery, didn't he?
He did, yes.
Chris, to do the same. Tell us about Street Smarts Ottawa.
So Street Smarts was started by Pete Cassidy back in 2002. Pete had addiction issues and ended up on the streets after some criminal charges. When he was out on the streets, he found that there was a lack of empathy for people suffering from social issues, mostly because people didn't understand them. So he devised Street Smarts basically himself at first, and he would take items that he could collect, and he would go on the streets and speak to people in the community and begin to develop relationships. Jewish Family Services became involved with the program when they met Pete and fell in love with his ideologies and his way of connecting with people. They picked up on the program, and they've been running it ever since.
And what is your story? I know we have some images of you doing the work that Pete started.
Yes.
And you say that you dealt with a lot of addiction, but you managed to avoid homelessness because of supportive family.
Yes, I had a major addiction when I was younger. In 2004 is when I got clean. I was 22 years old.
Congratulations.
It was very, very difficult, and thankfully I had the support of family, which a lot of people suffering from addictions don't get, again, because people don't understand. And when I became, when I got clean and sober, I started going to meetings and other things, and I met Pete through mutual friends. And Pete's, one of his ideologies is if you want to stay sober, you have to give back. He realized that I wasn't giving back at the time, and I was voluntold to start volunteering. So I started volunteering around 2005, which is one of the pictures actually that we provided has me in the dungeon, as we called it.
And we had an image of Pete at the end. I don't know if it was when he was giving it a little lineup, but we have a link on our website to Pete's Sparkle Fund, and we're going to tell you, there's Pete there, and we have information on that event, information on how you can get involved, and one of the aspects that I really, really like is you work with all of the other organizations. You work with the Mission, you work with the Salvation Army,
right.
You work with the Shepherds.
Yes, Street Smarts, we want to network with every organization because to really solve social issues, we have to work together. We can't just do our own thing. We have to be collaborative to figure out what the problem is and who can best help. So we work very closely with organizations such as Salvation Army, The Mission, Shepherds of Good Hope, Center 454, Youth Ottawa, just to name a few. Jewish Family Services obviously is very involved because they are running the program. And we attempt to get whatever help that person needs.
When we come back, we'll talk about the help. We'll talk about how you do that on the street. We'll talk about sort of a fun charity competition that Michael will share the details on when we come back, Michael.
Thanks, Leanne. Stay with us.